हेलो एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ टू क्रिएट द स्पिनिंग वीडियो क्यूब इन अडोबी प्रीमियर प्रो। बिफोर फर्दर प्रोसीडिंग आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक यू फॉर बीइंग हियर एंड सपोर्टिंग मी। इफ यू आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल प्लीज टू कंसीडर सब्सक्राइबिंग, दैट वुड बी हाईली अप्रिशिएटेड। लेट्स गेट इनटू प्रीमियर प्रो। I have imported 4 footages into the project and I have renamed them to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Create a new sequence. I am setting a 1920x1080 sequence with the frame rate of 25 and I am calling it as V1. Bring in the first footage into the timeline. Bring it down to the video track 1. We are going to need 10 seconds per video. Select the razor tool and cut at the 10 second mark and delete the extra portion. Create a new adjustment layer with the same settings as that of the sequence and drag it into the video track 2. Extend it to the time of the video clip and search for corner pin effect and apply it into the adjustment layer. At the 5 second mark, create keyframes for all the properties in the corner pin: upper left, upper right, lower left, lower right. Go to the start of the timeline and set the Y value of the upper right to 100 and the lower right to 980. That's plus 100 and minus 100. Go to the end of the timeline, that's 10 second mark, and set the upper left to 100 and the lower left to 980. That's again plus 100 and minus 100. Search for brightness and contrast effect and apply it into the adjustment layer. Set the brightness value to 100 and create a keyframe at the end of the timeline. And at the 5 second mark, set the value to 0. And at the start of the timeline, set the brightness value to minus 100. Search for transform effect and apply it into the adjustment layer. Uncheck the uniform scale. And at the 5 second mark, create keyframe for position and scale width. Go to the end of the timeline and set the position to 0 and also set the scale width to 0. Go to the start of the timeline, set the X value of the position to 1920 and the scale width to 0. Create a new sequence and I'm calling it as V2. Bring in the second footage into the timeline. Cut at the 10 second mark and delete the extra portions. Go to the V1 sequence and copy the adjustment layer and paste it to the V2 sequence. Drag it above the footage and repeat the process for the next 2 video clips. So now we have 4 sequences: V1, V2, V3 and V4. Create a new sequence and I am calling it as spinning cube. Drag all the sequences V1, V2, V3 and V4 into the timeline. At the 5 second mark, cut the V1 sequence and place it at the end of the sequence above V4. Drag the video clips to the start of the timeline and arrange them as shown. Create a new sequence and I am calling it as main. Drag the spinning cube sequence into the timeline. Duplicate it. Search for Gaussian blur effect and apply it into the video track 1. Set the blurriness to 500. Select the sequence of the video track and set the scale value to 50. Select the video track 2 sequence and uncheck the uniform scale. Set the scale height to 5 and the scale width to 50. Move the portion of the sequence to create a shadow-like effect. Search for brightness and contrast effect and apply it into the sequence at the video track 1. Set the brightness value to -50. And that's it, we have the spinning video cube. Hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post new videos. Like, comment and share, and thanks for being here and supporting me. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. This is Raudran signing off.